Hello there, welcome back. One from my Beer 52 Chicago box. This is an oatmeal stout from Beguile Brewing called Flannel Pajamas. Oh yeah, I've been looking forward to this one. We'll have a quick look on the can. Yeah, Beguile Brewery, Flannel Pajamas, oatmeal stout, Chicago, Illinois. I won't do a Chicago accent because I can't. Oatmeal stout. This smooth-bodied oatmeal stout features aromas of roast and cocoa and flavour notes of fudge, coffee and caramel. You know that feeling you get when you wake up on a cold morning in your favourite PJs and you can smell coffee already brewing? That's what this is. But beer. 5.4% ABV, 355 ml can. Let's crack it open. We'll see what it's like. That's my Christmas tree and my lights I've just put up. That is my concession to Christmas. Apart from that, I'm doing a beer advent calendar as well. It's very dark brown on the floor. A wee bit of carbonation there. 3/4 of an inch of tan, quite loose foam, sudsy. That's dissipating fast. It is absolutely beautiful. There's a ruby redness to it as well. I can see through the bottom that deep mahogany chestnut brown. I love that colour. Let's get a wee, release some aromas. I was expecting a massive hit of coffee. No. There is a hint of coffee there. But it's more like a toffee, a caramel malt. That's quite a boozy smell as well, for only a 5.4%. Normally I don't pick that up. Cheers, my dears. Coffee. Coffee's coming through now. Get like licorice. Very dark roast. Like deep roast vine fruits. Maybe dark raisins. That's very nice. It's quite thin at first, but then as it in your mouth, it's a bit more viscous. So it's probably medium bodied, I would say. It's a very nice beer. It's still developing. Love it. Let's break it down with the tasting sheet from craftbeer.com, and we'll do the light test first, see where that shows up, put it on highest setting, and we'll see if that picks up anything from below. I'm not sure it will. Yeah, it's picking up some of those nutty brown and very slightly reddish hues. That's absolutely beautiful, that. So the colour, we'll say it is between a 30 and a 40, 35. It's not completely black. It's very rarely you see a totally black beer. In fact, I don't think I've ever seen one. Correct me if I'm wrong. Clarity is, well, that's clear because I can see that light through it. Clear, a bit opaque. No, that doesn't make sense. Colour of foam head retention is poor. Foam texture thin. Visual carbonation, I can't see any. The aroma alcohol, there was a presence there. Mild. Hops, none. Malt, yeah. It's toast and caramel. Pruny, roasty. Am I getting any chocolate? It's hard to discern. Coffee for sure. I used to work in a chocolate factory, Rowntree Macintosh. We're now Nestle in Newcastle, in England. And I worked in the Smarties. And I hated the smell of that chocolate. After a while, really. And now I'm not keen on the smell of chocolate. Like, poor quality chocolate like that. Hope they don't sue me. So, flavour and aftertaste, the alcohol, I can't detect in the taste. Hop flavour, none. Hop bitterness, restrained. Yeah, the malt flavour, it's toasty and it's caramel and it's pruney. It's roasty and it's coffee. I'm not getting any chocolate, I don't think. You know, there's a fruitiness there as well. That's really nice. That's really nice. The malt sweetness, I'm going to say it's medium. It's no cloying or... Palate astringency is low. The body's soft. Palate carbonation's low. The length is long. More than 60 seconds. Balance and drinkability, desirable. Style, appropriate. It's a very nice beer. So, on Untapped, it's called Flannel Pyjamas. They spelt pyjamas wrong. Well, I'm not saying wrong. They spelt it differently. I'm not saying there's any rights or wrongs. There's massive differences between English and UK English and US English. I would spell it PYG, pyjamas. So it's actually an Indian word, pyjamas. Anyway. So it's from Beguile Brewing in... They're a microbrewery in Chicago, Illinois, United States. It's described as a stout oatmeal. 5.4% ABV. IBUs not listed. Two friends check-ins. Average 3.38. That's low. Everyone else just over 8,000 with an average of 3.62. That's fairer. See, there's some description. Coffee, chocolate and dried fruit. Very thin body, but it's nice enough. On first impressions, it felt quite thin, and then it does. The body sort of shines through, if that makes any sense. So the descriptors are oatmeal, coffee, smooth, dark, roasty. Yeah, I'm not picking up chocolate. So I'm going to give this... This is really, really nice, actually. Smooth and fully flavour. I'm going to give this 9 out of 10. I think that's very good. So, that's a winner. Big thumbs up for me. I look forward to the rest of my Chicago beers. This shirt is going to be walking about on its own by the time I've finished that box. I'm wearing it for every review. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time, hopefully. Ta-ta for now. Cheers, my dears. Yeah. That's very nice indeed.